World Series between the Washington Nationals and the New York Yankees. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vasgersian. Welcome to the World Series here on the show. I'm joined by Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, let's take a look at how these two ball clubs got to where they are.
Yeah, and you can see how these two teams stack up. And it's hard to say exactly who you'd get the edge to right now, but it wouldn't surprise me at all if the pitchers were the guys that got the upper hand in this series.
It's the moment these players have been waiting for. Game one of the Fall Classic is on the show, and it's coming up next. Now live as we count down to the start of Game 1, let's join public address announcer Mike Carlucci.
And now your 2016 New York Yankees!
Briefly now, we'll look at the two starters who get the ball here in Game 1. More from the guys as this one goes along, but first, let's give you a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Washington Nationals, and they'll align themselves like this here tonight. And there you see the starting pitcher they'll match up against as you look at his numbers on the right side of your screen. Denard Span move towards the batter's box as we're just about set to get underway tonight. Now a ball sliced hard on the ground. Ball on to first will take care of Span for the game's first out. So the leadoff man set down here in Game 1. And with that, let's give you a look at the Yankees' defense. It's brought to us by Majestic. Jason Worth will step in now as the designated hitter here in the World Series.
Yeah, and thanks to the American League's win in the All-Star game, we're going to have a DH in games 1, 2, 6, and 7. So maybe a chance for a little more offense than they're normally accustomed to.
First pitch coming. Now a hard hit ball back up the middle. Oh, a tough play. Oh, too late on the throw, but that is what you call a major league effort just to make that one close.
Well, what a great effort just to knock this one down before it gets into center field. But that was going to be asking a lot for him to get up and throw his man out. And as you can see there, that throw is well late.
Here's Bryce Harper now. Hit hard to short. But this is pulled in by the shortstop.
That's one of those plays where you might need to reinforce the laces on your glove after this inning ends. This is a fastball, and it is hammered. I mean, go for it.
Here's the catcher, Wilson Ramos. Pitch is a called strike, the throw. And this won't be in time as Wirth's able to swipe second base.
And later in the game, maybe you question this decision to run because you worry about taking the bat out of the hands of one of your best hitters. But here in a scoreless game, I doubt they're going to put him on. So that was a good job to take what's given to you.
He's ready. Now the pitch. And a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. One left for Washington. And now the Bombers will get their shot. No score. Starting lineup for the Yankees, as presented by Joe Girardi, will look like this. They'll match up against an imposing presence indeed. The number one overall pick in 2009, hard-throwing right-hander Steven Strasburg. And defensively, here's how Washington will take the field behind him. Jacoby Ellsbury will stand in now for the first time here in this World Series, and he's a guy this club really needs to get going.
Yeah, it's been a tough October for him so far. He just seemed a little overmatched in the games that we've watched. It looks like he's just trying too hard, and sometimes that just puts more pressure on him.
And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. One strike home now to Ellsbury. Here's a hard hit ball back up the middle. On to first is Desmond, and that's in time for the first out.
Adding second, the shortstop, Nevrin Cabrera.
Nevrin Cabrera will stand in. Now here's the first pitch. Now here's a swing and another chance out there at short. And the throw will not be in time, as I don't think he was going to get him anyway, but a fine effort nonetheless.
But this would have taken a superhuman effort right here, deep in the hole. You see, he doesn't have time to plant himself, so he just leaps into the air, fires it across the diamond. Just a great effort, but this was always going to be a base hit.
Alex Rodriguez pitches a cold strike to throw. Not in time as he steals second.
Just your classic single and a stolen base. Now with one out in the first, another base hit here, you put that first run on the board.
Now a spin and a throw back to second, and he's back easily. One out and a runner on second base. From the belt, the tip. Pitch swung out and missed the throw.
And that's a big play right there. He picked a great pitch to run on. A big, slow breaking ball. And now you've got an important run all the way over to third base now with just one out. And now a fly ball could bring you in the score.
Two-strike pitch from Strasburg. And a swing and a miss as they caught him reaching that time, and there are two away.
Yeah, and that's a big second out right there, and that's going to keep that runner anchored over there at third base. So they may wind up not getting that first run across after all.
David Rosario will stand in for the first time here in this World Series, and you see the numbers. He's been as hot as anybody around.
maybe the hottest hitter on the ball club through the first few rounds. If he can keep it going here in the World Series, I think they're going to have a good shot at going all the way.
First pitch on the way. It goes the other way as this is hit well out toward deep left field. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. Second inning upcoming here in the Bronx with no score. Anthony Rendon leads things off now in the top half of the second. And it's the outside corner, it's strike one. Here it comes. Swung on and hit pretty well out to deep left field. And, oh, he missed a home run by a matter of feet. It's off the wall. And he is in there safely as he starts the second with a double. Ryan Zimmerman will stand in now with a good chance to break the seal here following the leadoff double.
Well, it's a good RBI opportunity, but you've got to remember your first job, which is to at least get that guy over to third base.
And the throw to first is in time, one gone.
And you know what? It's never too early in a ball game to play smart, fundamental baseball. You've got the leadoff man at second, so he's just shooting for the right side of the infield. And he's able to move him up 90 feet to third with just one away.
Ian Desmond will step in here with a runner at third now, so maybe an important at-bat here early in the ball game.
Yeah, I think you really need to get something out of this inning. Even if it's just a sacrifice fly. If you let this guy off the hook, he might not even give you another chance.
And this is fouled back and out of play. From the stretch. Has to fight to stay alive as this is fouled off to the right. Ready with another 0-2. And a swing and a miss as they caught him reaching that time, and there are two away.
Well, he's done a pretty good job here of rendering that beat-off double useless. Come back with a ground out, then a strikeout. And so now it's going to come down to a two-out base hit. They want to score right here.
Curtis Granderson will get his first shot here, trying to come through with two away and a runner at third. Now the first pitch. Called strike to the 35-year-old veteran. Nothing in one. No score at this point, but a two-out hit could get a runner in from third. Now a swing and a miss there from Granderson, and he's quickly down here 0-2.
And he's really going to have to fight now. You got to take a little bit out of your swing and find a way to put this ball in play.
And a half-hearted swing there as they tie him up inside for the third strike, and the inning is over. Back-to-back strikeouts keep him out of danger. Back with more from Game 1. After this. Mark Teixeira will start things off in the bottom of the second. Infield in the overshift here, now the pitch. And he waves at a curveball there. No balls and a strike. Now here it comes. Swinging a ball hit softly on the ground. But this will be a foul ball as he's behind 0-2 now. Two strike pitch from Strasburg. Oh, and he leaves that one right over the plate as this is hit high and deep out to right center field. And it is gone, a home run. So a solo shot off the bat of Mark Teixeira. His first homer here in the series as the Yankees will grab a 1-0 lead. We'll be right back.
outfielders anywhere you want, but unless you've got somebody stationed out there in the cheap seats, it ain't going to matter much. Watch that one.
Into the box, Bruno Chiavacci. He'll pick on the first pitch and hit a ground ball towards second. And that is through into center field, a base hit.
Here's a case on the mound where he's trying to sneak the first pitch fastball line. He was having none of that at the plate. He just sends it right back where it came from.
Behind the plate, it's strike one. Reddick waiting, and now the pitch. And this ball's heading for the seats down the right side as the count will move to 0-2 now. He's set, now the pitch. And a bouncing ball, foul. Safely. Nobody out, runner on first. Here's another 0-2. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. Now another 0-2. They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
Yeah, not a real good job of pitch recognition there. I mean, this ball was going to be in on his hands to begin with. I don't know quite what he saw that made him want to swing at that thing, but it just completely locked him up.
Before the first pitch, a check at first. And the runner back. And again a throw, and he just manages to get his hand in. Once more, a throw over, and he'll get back in safely. Here's Brett Gardner now. Well down the line in right. This ball has a chance, and it is gone. A home run. So a two-run homer down the line in right field. His first homer so far in the series as the Yankees move out to a 3-0 lead.
They're starting to make it look awfully easy out there. He gets a pitch he can handle. This becomes his second home run here in the inning, so they're starting to get some pretty good swings again.
Here's Didi Gregorius. He will swing at the first pitch and send a ground ball out to short. Throw just in time, and oh, that was awfully close. But hold on here now. He jumped out of that dugout in a hurry. He might ask for that out pole to be reviewed.
Yeah, he wasn't so sure that was the right call. And looking at it again right here, I don't know if I can tell for sure either. We'll wait to see what the guys in the dugout say after reviewing this play a couple of times, probably.
So here's the signal from the dugout, and it appears they will decide not to challenge the call on the field, so the runner is out at first. So bases are empty here with two gone, and it's back to the top of the order now for Jacoby Ellsbury. And he swings through a fastball and doesn't catch up with it. It's 0-1. very difficult to get on top of the pitch when it's coming in that high.
Darn near impossible when it's coming at you in the high 90s. You just can't get your hands up there fast enough to stay on top.
Swinging a ball hit on the ground. But this will wind up a foul ball, strike two. Now the pitch home to Ellsbury. And this one runs in on him as he can't get his arms extended. A great pitch there, and the inning is over. Yunel Escobar will step in here to start their half of the third with the top of the order to follow. And the throw here is in time. Very nicely done there at short for the first down.
But this is just a nice play right here, ranging up the middle. You can see that he doesn't try to rush things here. He just gathers it, steadies himself just for a brief second to square himself up, and then makes a good throw on target to get his man.
Here's the center fielder, Denard Span, as he looks at a fastball that misses off the plate for ball one. And he pulls it to deep right field. And he will run this one down. A good read off the bat for the second out. And with two away here in game one of the World Series, let's give you a little refresher, of course, at the roads these two teams took to get where they are tonight. Jason Wirt will dig in. He singled his first time around. Ooh, started him with the change, and it's nothing in one.
Boy, he's got that thing going good. It just takes a nosedive right at the end.
Now the pitch. That's on the ground to short. This should end the inning. Oh, and he can't come up with it. And some problems defensively as they allow him to reach first safely.
Not really all that tough a play heading up the middle, but you see it takes a funny little hop there at the end, and this will be scored as an error.
Bryce Harper get a shot here in the inning after all, as that two-out error could really turn out to have some major consequences.
Yeah, anytime you get this guy in that bat, especially with a runner on base that he otherwise wouldn't have had, you're asking for trouble.
He's set. Now the pitch. Oh, and he turns beautifully on that fastball as this is pulled into right for a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
And this is a situation now on the mound where you can't worry about how you got into it. You've got to worry about how you're going to get out of it. And he's got some work to do now to protect this lead.
Wilson Ramos will stand in with two on and two out here in the third. And a fastball's in there for strike one. Seems like he's gotten away with more than a few location mistakes so far.
Yeah, and that's not going to last forever, especially in this place.
He waits. Now the pitch. He's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
And in a spot like this, first and second with two.
And meanwhile, this pitch gets away from him. So now two men in scoring position.
Yeah, and that's always the danger when you're working that off-speed stuff down with two men on base. Once the catcher can't get a handle on it, both guys...
Hold that thought as this one is deep down the line and left, hooking, but it's a fair ball, home run. A three-run shot down the line and left, his first homer here in the series, and the Nationals have drawn even now at 3-3.
He's a strike away from getting out of this unscored upon, but you can see the location mistake there. And now, all of a sudden, he goes from possibly hanging a goose egg to serving up a three-run home run.
In now is Anthony Rendon. As he takes a cold strike at the knees, it's 0-1.
Yeah, same pitch here from the home run ball, but this one's in a much better spot down at the knees.
And this is hit hard on the ground at first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. But the Nationals strike for three all coming via this three-run home run. Bottom of the third coming up, and we are all tied at three apiece. Everett Cabrera makes his way to the plate to get us started here in the bottom of inning number three. Here's the first pitch to him. And he'll look at a first pitch curveball that's in the dirt. It's ball one.
He just about went around. He was lucky to put on the brakes when he did.
The 1-0. Tries to go the other way as this is in the air to left field. Under it is Granderson, one away.
Well, you know, he had the right idea up there, so at least you know he's thinking. He tried to go the other way with this ball, but he got under it just a little bit, and it's an easy play out there in left field.
So the bases are empty with one man gone. And set to stand in the still very imposing figure of the three-time MVP, Alex Rodriguez. First pitch hack in here, and that's the first strike. Here's the pitch. There's a chopper foul over to the right side. 0-2 now. Hits are now even at four apiece. Now here's the pitch. Oh, and he dusted him off the plate that time. Some mind games being played now. It's 1-2.
He did not like that one bit. You know, it's one thing to work in with the hard stuff. But don't do it around the dome.
Here comes a 1-2. Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two.
Well, this curveball right here has got a lot of snap to it. You can see pretty clearly he's finishing off his pitches much, much better than earlier in the ballgame. He's getting much better results as well.
Into the box now, David Rosario. As the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one. Two out, nobody on. Here's a 1-0. This ball will be chopped foul. Here comes the 1-1. Starts to go around, but the home plate umpire says he held up ball two.
You know, sometimes when you're thinking fastball, you try to get moving just a little bit early. That's a good job of recognizing off speed and then holding back on the swing.
And he goes the other way as this is hit high and deep out to straightaway left. And it'll stay in the park as it hits high off the right field wall. Around second now, and they still haven't flagged this one down. And he is all the way over to third now with a two-out triple.
Well, that was an all-or-nothing play out there in left field. You see, tracking it all the way, but it's time to jump here. This is gonna hit off the wall. So by the time he's able to retrieve it, it's too late to prevent this from becoming a triple.
First pitch coming. And no swing apparently, ball one. Danger here after the two-out triple as the inning is over. No damage done after the two-out triple. We're back with more of Game 1 after this message and a word from our local station. Ryan Zimmerman will stand in now to get us going here in the fourth. And he'll take strike one on the fastball, registering at 93 that time. pitch on the way. Now here's a ground ball that'll get by the mound and into center field for a leadoff single.
All right. So now batting. Ian Desmond.
Here's the shortstop, Ian Desmond, as he'll take a look at ball one.
And right about now, you gotta know as a hitter that you're gonna see a heavy dose of that splitter. That's a good take up there to get ahead.
And this is pulled foul as he was way out in front there. The 1-1. Now a ball swung on and heading for the stands in right, and that'll move the count to 1-2 now. Now a changeup locks him up as he looks at strike three called, one away.
Boy, and just a great call that time in terms of the changeup. That's one of those at the plate where you don't even wait for the umpire to make the call. You know you're wrong.
Curtis Granderson will get another shot, called out on strikes his first time around.
Yeah.
And he starts the number eight hitter with a strike, nothing in one. And a splitter here, but he had a bit too much on it as this bounces up to the plate.
You gotta figure we'll start seeing a pretty heavy dose of that splitter. This is a situation that absolutely calls for.
Hits are even right now at five aside. And Granderson swings and misses that time as he's down on strikes for out number two. So after getting the strikeout on the fastball, not a bad time to check out our pitch speed comparison for our two starters. We've got two guys bringing some serious gas for you, as you see there. Top speeds 96 and 97. Yunel Escobar will stand in. He grounded out his first time. Now the first pitch. Now a hard hit ball back up the middle. And Escobar has a base hit.
Yeah. He hit a good pitch there. This thing's toward the outside part of the plate, but he stays with it all the way. Uses the big part of the field and gets himself a base hit.
Here's the center fielder, Denard Span. And he'll take a changeup here for strike one.
And you know, this is a guy that loves the ball down and in. It's one of the locations he really covers well, so they're gonna wanna mix their spots here.
Now a ground ball towards the hole. Throw on to first is going to get him, and the Nationals blow an opportunity here, and that ends the inning. Nats leave a pair. Through three and a half, we're all even at three apiece. Bruno Giovanni will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth.
Bruno Giovanni.
First pitch to him. Not fooled there as this ball's hammered out to deep right field. And this one is gone. A home run to lead off the bottom of the fourth. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. His first homer so far in the series as they take the lead 4-3.
This is what you expect when you make it to the postseason. You expect the guys that have carried you all year to keep on producing. And sure enough, he comes through again and delivers a no-doubter.
Stepping in is Josh Reddick. He'll pick on the first pitch and hit a ground ball towards second. Throw not nearly in time, so despite the great effort, that'll go into the books as an infield single.
And the key to this is that he's running hard out of the batter's box all the way. You know, with some guys, it's not always the case. But he has really busted it down the line, and he's going to get rewarded with an infield hit.
Strasburg with a check at first. Oh, and it froze him, and they got him. Now, here's the first pitch. Brett Gardner swings and misses there, so he's down 0-1. Now the Yankees, with their three home runs now, still have a ways to go to match their record for a single game. Twice in their history, they've hit eight of them, most recently in 2007. Swing and a broken bat as this ball's hit on the ground. And he can't pick it up. That ought to go down as an infield single. And now in with a run in, one out and one on here in the inning. Throw over to first, and he'll dive back in safely.
Out there right now. He has to find some confidence in those secondary pitches, and that's a good change up there.
Now a pickoff play at second. Runner back standing. The right-hander deals on 1-2. And this is going to find the crowd down the left field line. Count holds at 1-2. There at second, here's the pitch. Taken the other way toward left center and fairly deep. Spann falls off the left fielder as he takes charge for the second out.
We'll take a look here at his pitch count. You can see, at least early on, been around the plate quite a bit. 36 strikes so far, but that's a sign that his location is where it needs to be.
Jacoby Ellsbury will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips. Grounded fouled off to the right side. Four runs, eight hits, and one error on the Yankee line score so far. One strike home now to Ellsbury. He couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the plane of the plate, and that will be ruled a strike. Good lead off a second there. Now the pitch. And he reaches for one but can't find it as he's down on strikes for the final out. The Yankees do get one on the solo homer. We played four. It's now 4-3 Bombers. Jason Wirth will make his way towards the box to lead off the fifth. And he'll power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one. The pitch count there, one pitch into his fifth inning of work. Not much of a concern, I wouldn't imagine.
Yeah, it should be. He hasn't had any real overtaxed innings, so he should be fine for the time being.
A little bit off the outside, it's 1-2. Pretty clear the plan is to keep everything away. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second. From a knee, he gets him. What a play.
Well, you always talk about wanting a second baseman that's got some good range. Well, try this one on for size. I mean, he's way out there on the outfield grass, but he pulls this one in, pops up to a knee, and then whips that ball over to first to get his man.
Here's Bryce Harper now. He'll look at a fastball in there on the outer half. It's 0-1. And now pitch on the way. Swing and a miss as he falls behind, nothing and two.
And on 0-2, I'd be shocked to see another fastball to strike.
We're in the fifth inning of a 4-3 ball game here. Ball swung on and hit high down the line in left, but it'll get back in among the crowd, so the count holds at 0-2. And this is swung on and missed, so it's two up, two down to start the fifth.
Well, apparently he just got his gas tank refilled during the last half inning because he's come out looking as sharp as he has in the whole ballgame.
Wilson Ramos is at the plate here as he quickly finds himself down a strike. It's 0-1.
And it looks like he's rebounded pretty well from that rough inning a couple innings back. He put up a zero last time, and he's close to doing it again.
And that's in there as well, 0-2 now.
Yeah, he came with a little bit of a different look that time. This pitch is also in there knee-high, and now they've got him behind in the count, 0-2.
Whoa. Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2.
I think that fastball is just for show there. He's not trying to throw this for a strike.
Now the 1-2. Foul back. Another 1-2 delivery. Chopper foul. Here he comes again, 1-2. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Nationals gone in order. Still down a run, it's 4-3. Everett Cabrera will dig in now. A single and a flyout for him in two trips thus far. Went about halfway there, but it's a called strike regardless. Here it comes. Now the 0-1 pitch is swung on and hit out to Desmond at short. Throw on to first, and one shortstop grounds out to the other, one away. Alex Rodriguez will stand in now. A punch-out victim twice already. EK, I'll ask you because you're the one sitting next to me. Do you approach an at-bat differently when you have two strikeouts under your belt this early in the game?
Well, you do in the sense that whatever you did the first two times, it wasn't working. But I think if you start worrying too much about trying to avoid the hat trick, or worse, it'll start becoming a mind game. You'll start falling into some pretty bad habits.
David Rosario will stand in. He tripled in his last appearance. First offering on the way. Breaking ball that's cut on and missed for the first strike.
Well, he's really starting to hit his stride here in this fifth inning.
And the pitch. Oh, got a swing out of his shoes on that one. Nothing in two.
And I'll tell you, being in a two-strike hole is not the spot you want to be in against a guy like this.
Two-strike pitch from Strasburg. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Here comes another 0-2. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Four runs, eight hits. One error on the Yankee line score so far. Grounded foul. The pitch. Half-hearted swing there as they tie him up inside for the third strike, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Bombers, but they hold on to a 4-3 lead. Anthony Rendon will stand in, and he'll lead off in the Washington 6. Now here's the ball hit high and deep out to left center field. And he will make the nice running catch out there as he had to travel a long distance to rein that one in. Ryan Zimmerman will dig in, 1-for-2. He grounded out the first time and followed that with a base hit in his second plate appearance. And the sixth inning is progressing quickly here, now 2 away. Ian Desmond will stand in, called out on strikes his last time. In there at the knees, strike one.
And you can see him trying to be a little bit more patient here. He's got two strikeouts already, but he's got to be careful not to fall too far behind.
That's on the ground to short. This should end the inning. And indeed it will. He throws him out at first, and the side is retired. Three up, three down for Washington. They still trail it here, 4-3. Mark Teixeira will stand in here hoping to duplicate it when he gets back in the second inning. Flashes back to take another look at a solo home run. going to get a left-hander up and throwing in the bullpen. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. Here's a swing and a high pop-up drifting toward the third base dugout. And he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one.
Yeah, a good pitch there as he gets the pop out on the fastball as we take a look at his pitch right now.
Bruno Giovacci will dig in. A home run his last time. So a rather weak start to the at-bat as he misses badly there. It's 0-1. Think you'll see another one of those before this at-bat's through?
After that swing, I think you can just about take that to the bank.
There's a hard hit ball that's going to get over the head of Desmond to short. It's a base hit.
Boy, not only was that pitch very tight on him, but it got there in a hurry. You can see he's barely able to get the bat through the zone, but somehow he manages to steer it into left field for a base hit.
Stepping in is Josh Reddick. Now a swing as he rifles this one into center for a base hit.
And this is what you want to do when you've got a guy on the road. Just keep hammering away at him. Here's a first pitch single. That's back-to-back hits. He may be in some serious trouble out there on the mound right now.
On his way out to the mound now, the Washington manager. That's going to do it now for Steven Strasburg. Gone after 5 1/3 here as he never really found his groove in this one. Ryan Dunsing will come on and try to get out of this mess here as there are two on with only one away.
Ryan Dunsing.
Brett Gardner now. Yes, he'll pick on the first pitch and hit a ground ball towards second. On the first, and how about that for an entrance? One pitch, two outs, and the inning is over. 4-6-3. They roll it up to get out of the jam. Back with more from Game 1 after this. Back here in the Bronx. Seventh inning coming up now in Game 1 as we take a look there at our game summary through the first six innings so far. Curtis Granderson will lead it off here in the top of inning number 7.
Curtis Granderson.
Here's the first offering. Fastball in there for a called strike. Now here's the pitch. And here's a foul tip into the catcher's glove. Moves it to 0-2 now.
I think that's been his best pitch so far in this game. Guys just haven't been all that close to it.
Just a touch outside. 1-2. Here's the pitch. And he struck him out. And there's the hat trick. And that's his third strikeout of the ballgame.
Well, it's not going to comfort him any, but it's fair to say he's not the first guy to strike out three times against that guy out there on the hill. He's just the latest in a long line of guys that wore the hat against that man.
Yunel Escobar comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one.
Yeah, he's definitely still bringing it. It's the seventh inning, and we're still here, and the catcher's been snapping all the way up here.
Swinging a ball hit softly on the ground. Now the pitch. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but a foul ball, and the count holds at 0-2. Now the pitch. Struck him out, and he becomes the ninth strikeout victim thus far.
Second strikeout for him here in the inning. Making that 9 now in the ballgame. He is just carving these guys up.
center fielder Denard Span, as he'll take a look at an off-speed pitch here that misses for ball one. 1-0 on the way. Called strike at the knees, 1-1. Here it comes. 1-1 pitch is a splitter, called strike two.
And this isn't the first guy that's been frozen by that pitch tonight. He's had a lot of guys shaking their heads.
We're in the seventh inning now of a 4-3 ball game. And this is hit hard on the ground towards short. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Nationals gone in order. Score holds at 4-3. Didi Gregorius will stand in. One of the few guys not to join the hit parade so far. Here's a hard hit ball back up the middle. What a stop! Throw from a knee is too late, and that will be an infield single.
Boy, what a great effort just to knock this one down before it gets into center field. But that was going to be asking a lot for him to get up and throw his man out. And as you can see there, that throw is well late.
So a runner at first now with nobody out, and that'll bring in the center fielder, Jacoby Ellsbury. And here's the first pitch. One attempt misses. The throw down. Way late, and he's in there easily in second.
Here's a situation where there's a new reliever out there. You know he's going to be focused on getting ahead, and boom, you take off on the first pitch. Now you've really given him something to think about.
Now the pitch home to Ellsbury. Now here's a little tapper down that third baseline, and this could be a tough play. But this will get foul for strike two. Decent lead at second. Here's the pitch. This is lifted the other way out to left center. Granderson arranged to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the first down.
With the 0-2 count, he was really forced to protect the plate, and you can see this ball's not even in the strike zone. He chases after it anyway, and he lifts this for an easy fly ball.
Spinning a throw back to second, and he'll get back in standing. Here's the shortstop, Everett Cabrera, as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce one foul for the first strike. Has a look, now the pitch. And he checks his swing. Did he go around? Yes, says the first base umpire. Strike two. Steps off the second there. Now the pitch. Pitch in the dirt is swung on and missed, so he'll need to get the force at first. Throw to first will take care of him. Score it 2-3 on the put out, and there are two gone now.
Yeah, that turns out to be a nice little play there behind the plate. They get the swing through for strike three, but then he's got to get the out over there at first base and make sure that nobody else advances. He's able to accomplish both of those tasks.
Alex Rodriguez. Step in now in a big spot here in a game as close as this one.
And a chance at redemption, too, because he hasn't done much through his first three plate appearances.
But that'll hit off the wall in left center. And this will score the run from second to make this a 5-3 game now.
And in a game like this, there's no telling how important an insurance run that may turn out to be. He plates that run on the RBI double to make it a two-run lead now. It may not sound like that much, but it makes a world of difference for anyone who's coming in to try to close this game.
David Rosario will step in with a big opportunity to get that insurance run home from second. And ball four here on the intentional walk, so now they'll have a force at any base with two gone. Mark Teixeira. Teixeira will get his shot now with two on and two out here in inning number seven. First pitch on its way to Teixeira. Just a miserable effort there. It's 0-1.
Man, not a real good effort there. That pitch was never going to be a strike.
He's ready now. The pitch. Slider taken here. One ball, one strike. Nail-biting time now in that third base dugout.
Well, things are starting to spiral here, and you've got to make sure this doesn't spin completely out of control.
Two men are on with two men out. Here's the 1-1 home to Tex. Tough to get fooled any worse than that. He's in a hole now, 1-2. Where do you think they go from here?
And maybe double up and go back to another off-speed pitch. Didn't handle that one all too well.
And maybe an excuse-me swing there as this is tapped in front of the mound. And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out. One for the Yankees on the A-Rod RBI double. Seven complete here tonight. It's now 5-3 New York. Jason Wirth will start things off here for Washington with Bryce Harper on deck due to hit second. Watches a fastball right there for strike one.
And here's where you don't need to be an RBI guy. You don't need to be a home run guy. You have to be a leadoff guy. Just get on base somehow to give that tying run on deck a shot.
And Wirth, among the best in baseball a couple of years ago, working the count. He's got it to 3-1 now. Now a big swing, and this is a major league pop-up way up there toward the center of the diamond. And A-Rod will look this one in for the first out. Still anyone's ball game. 5-3 is our score as we take a look now at the starter comparison to see how these two guys fared in the matchup. Bryce Harper sets the plate now as he looks at strike one.
Getting that first pitch strike is so important against a guy like this. You have to be able to work ahead in the count and not let him dictate the at-bat.
One out, nobody on. And he goes with the 0-2 here as this is on the ground to third. Throw gets him, two down. Eighth inning from Yankee Stadium. Yankees on top in this one at home as you get a look at the line score. Wilson Ramos will stand in again as we flash you back to earlier. He's accounted for their only runs of the ballgame on one swing of the bat as this was the swing right here. Swing and a ball line hard towards short. And a bit of a high throw that time, but not much problem over there at first as that will end the inning. Three up, three down for Washington. They're still down 5-3.
Your attention, please.
New pitcher coming on now, and it's the 6-4 right-hander out of UCLA, Casey Jansen. Bruno Giovacci will be the first one to greet him here as he'll be forced to turn around and hit from the left side now. Action now in the Washington bullpen as a right-hander begins to get loose. On, he leaves the fastball up there. Mistake in location. He is going to pay for it dearly as that ball is sent over the wall. A home run. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. His second of the game, and it's now 6-3.
Guys, you wonder if this home run makes it an easier decision to send that starter back out there to maybe finish this one off himself. That gives him an extra bit of leeway here, and I have a feeling that might just sway their manager's decision into letting him try to go out there and notch the complete game.
Stepping in is Josh Reddick. Fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul. Reddick waiting, and now the pitch. And that swung on and fouled straight back. And the pitch. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. But this will be a foul ball, and it's still 0-2. The pitch. And there's the good curve. curveball as he set down on strikes for the second time here tonight.
Well, you know, Eric and I like to talk a lot about pitchers keeping hitters off balance at the plate. And this is an excellent illustration of what we're talking about. Now, we didn't like to be off balance at the plate, but this is what you get. He goes fast, then slow, fast, then slow. They never give him the same pitch or the same speed twice in a row. And that's how you keep the guy's time and fall messed up.
Here's Brett Gardner now. Now a swing, and he pops him up right up the chute. This may be tough behind the plate. And he'll put this one away in foul territory for the second out.
Might have had visions of another home run there.
This pitch is right in his wheelhouse, but he winds up swinging right underneath it, popping it straight up.
Here's Didi Gregorius. Hangs on him a bit that time as it's belted out toward deep center field. Span retreats to the track, and he'll put this one away. So a sigh of relief as the side is retired. The Yanks able to add on one more via the solo home run. Last chance coming up here for the Nationals. New York leads it 6-3. Anthony Rendon will stand in, needing to get things started here in the top of the ninth. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway.
And I like the call to leave him in there instead of going with the closer with the three-run lead. Ride the hot hand. Don't burn up your closer unless you really need to.
Ryan Zimmerman will stand in, needing to do something here to get on base as they're down to their final two outs. Now here's the pitch. That's taken. Now it's 0-2. Now here's the pitch. Hit hard but foul to the left, and they'll try it again. Another 0-2 home. And here's a ball hit in the air. And he'll stay with it to put it away as they get their man here for the second out.
Here's a spot where he's probably looking for something hard again. But instead, they change up on him, get him out in front a little, and all he can do is pop it straight up.
Ian Desmond will stand in as their last chance now. And he'll power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one. Bases are empty here with two men out. Here's the pitch. Taken, called strike two, and now they're down to their final strike tonight. Crowd of over 39,000 on their feet. A little bit off the outside, it's 1-2.
But you don't want to get caught looking on the final out, so that's a tough
swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Well, we talked about how they needed a good outing out of this guy, and he gave them that and even more, finishing off the complete game victory.
Come out on top, 6-3. good night from the Bronx.